to the Clinton Township Planning Commission meeting for Thursday, April 22nd. Ms. Cherry, will you please lead us in our Pledge of Allegiance?
Madam Chair, I would love to. I pledge allegiance to the flag of these United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Just a few house rules before we get started. Tonight, we are operating under the township's emergency order for remote meetings. We encourage you to voice your opinion on the topic being discussed. Prior to and during the meeting, you can send your questions to planningcommission@clintontownship-mi.gov. Again, that email address is planningcommission@clintontownship-mi.gov. Throughout the meeting and on agenda items, your email relating to a specific agenda item will be read prior to the board voting on each agenda item. Further, following consideration of all the agenda items, persons who have connected remotely will be permitted to speak. Existing rules regarding public participation otherwise fully apply. And also, before we get started, I would like to introduce our newest member, Mr. Matt Ritter.
Hello, Matt, thank you, everyone.
We are glad to have you on board.
Glad to be here.
Madam Secretary, roll call, please.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Ms. Cherry is obviously here. Mr. Curd?
Here.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Here.
Madam Mosley?
Here.
Mr. Opaleski?
Excused.
Ms. Patton?
Here.
Mr. Ritter?
Here.
And Ms. Trombley?
Here.
And also in attendance tonight, we have the Township Planner, Mr. Bruce Thompson.
Thank you. The next item is the approval of the agenda. Are there any additions or deletions?
None.
If there are none, is there a motion?
I'll make a motion.
I'll second.
Madam Secretary, roll call, please.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Curd?
Yes.
Ms. Cherry? Yes. Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Ritter?
Yes.
And Ms. Trombley?
Yes.
Thank you. Item number one on the agenda is 0.5 acres of land located on the west side of Harper, north of 15 Mile Road. This is address 35105 Harper. This is a site development plan for Checker drive-through bun freezer addition. Secretary, is there correspondence?
Madam Chair, I have 19 items mailed for this agenda item with none returned and no correspondence at this time.
Thank you. Mr. Thompson?
Thank you. So if everybody can look at the screen, we have the copy of the site plan the petitioner submitted. It also includes a photo of that freezer. And so what they're looking at doing is at this site on the west side of Harper, north of 15, they have a 1,425 square foot building. It was a Checkers. We're fortunate these folks are reopening it as a Checkers. They are proposing an 8x14 freestanding freezer in the landscape area, which is right here behind the actual store itself. And so, as you can see, this is the freezer itself. It's white, so it will match the exterior of the building. And then as well, they are proposing to add a canopy over the drive-through. There's a little bump-out improvement that will be done at the drive-through, and then a canopy that will extend out over that drive-through. The materials of that will also match the building. Otherwise, the site remains as it is. It's currently in accordance with its approved site plan, so lighting, signage, landscaping, screening, all those things, parking will all remain the same. This plan meets ordinance requirements, therefore approval is recommended. Thank you.
Thank you. For those of you in our listening audience, if you're not speaking at the time, if you could please mute your microphone, we would greatly appreciate it. That'll cut down on any feedback that we receive. Is the petitioner present for this matter?
Yes, I am. My name is Mike Rea. I am the construction company handling this for the, applicant, or, well, I'm the applicant, I guess, for the new Checkers franchisee, Paul Amel.
Mr. Rea, can you just please restate your address for the record, please?
Yes, I'm sorry. My address is 24001 Telegraph Road, Southfield, Michigan, 48033.
Thank you. Mr. Rea, do you have anything you'd like to add to this matter?
I do not. I think Mr. Thompson summed it up, but I'd be happy to answer any questions if there are any.
Thank you, Mr. Rea. Questions or comments from the commissioners at this time? Is there anyone in our listening or viewing audience that would like to speak to this matter? Seeing and hearing no one, is there a motion?
I'll make a motion.
I'll second that.
Ms. Patton, you're making a motion to
approve the site plan for the freezer.
Thank you. I'm sorry. And who seconded that motion? That's Mr. DeBartolomeo. Madam Secretary, roll call, please.
Ms. Patton.
Yes.
Mr. DeBartolomeo.
Yes.
Ms. Cherry, yes. Mr. Curd.
Yes.
Ms. Mosley.
Yes.
Mr. Ritter.
Yes.
And Ms. Tremblay.
Yes.
Thank you. The motion passes. Mr. Rea.
Yes.
Good luck to you all.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Item number two on the agenda is a public hearing. And this is regarding 2.31 acres fronting the east line of Hayes Road, south of Canal Road. This is a special land use for a tattoo parlor located at 41972 Hayes Road in the Windmill Plaza. This is also a public hearing, as I stated. Madam Secretary, is there correspondence?
Madam Chair, on this agenda item, I have 53 items mailed with none returned and no correspondence at this time.
Thank you. Mr. Thompson?
Thank you. Again, if everybody can just refer to the screen, I couldn't find a very viable site plan to show you, so I brought up an aerial photograph. Obviously, for those that have been by the site and looked at it, this is an established shopping center. It's owned B2 Community Business. It's a 19,000, just a little over 19,000 square foot building. And the petitioner is requesting the ability to operate the Ink Spot Tattoo Shop in an 1,100 square foot space. The petitioner did provide you, I believe, with a good deal of information, fortunately. That certainly helps in reviewing these things. But from a standpoint of application of the special land use standards, we find that the use will be located in an existing building, and it is a building that has similar service retail uses. So the use would be in harmony with the site and adjacent commercial areas. The site contains adequate access and parking. Those things aren't going to change. There's two access driveways to Hayes, and there's over 90 parking spaces on this site. This particular use will not create any burden to the existing parking lot, and certainly won't generate any traffic any more than any other uses within this shopping center. It'll be located entirely within the building, so there won't be any nuisance to the public or any of the surrounding properties. You won't know it's there other than customers and obviously the sign on the front of the building. The proposed use, again, located in the existing building, will not change the structure, will not change the site, so it will not alter the orderly development of the property. This is a commercial use in an area that is master planned for commercial, so the use is as well consistent with the township's master plan. As a result, we are recommending that you forward this case to the Township Board with a recommendation for approval. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Thompson. The petitioner is present for this matter.
Yes, I'm here.
If you could please state your name and address for the record, please.
Jessica Steffen. Do you want the business address or my home address?
The business is good.
41972 Hayes Road.
Thank you. Ms. Steffen, do you have anything you'd like to add to this matter?
I do not have a concern.
Thank you. As I mentioned earlier, this is a public hearing. Is there a motion to open the public hearing?
A move to open the public hearing.
Mr. Kurd, is there support?
I support.
Shall we give that to Ms. Cherry?
Yes, why not?
Yes, let's give that to Ms. Cherry.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Patton.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Ms. Cherry, yes. Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. Ritter?
Yes.
And Ms. Trombley?
Yes. Thank you. Is there anyone in our viewing or listening audience that would like to speak to this matter? Seeing and hearing no one to speak to this matter, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
I'll make a motion to close the public hearing.
I'm sorry, was that Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Ms. Cherry, roll call, please.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Ms. Cherry, yes. Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Ritter?
Yes.
And Ms. Trombley?
Yes. Thank you. Public hearing is closed. Any questions or comments from the commissioners at this time?
Madam Chair?
Mr. Kurd?
Thank you. I just, to Ms. Stephan, thank you for all the background information that you shared with us. The business has been in business for quite a long time. You've been operating it since 2014. Having to relocate, glad you're willing to relocate within Clinton Township. And I'm for, just as individually, I'm for approving the special use.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kurd. Any other questions or comments from our commissioners at this time? If there are no other questions or comments, is there a motion?
I'll make a motion.
Oh, we have got to get it together. Okay. Ms. Patton, you want to take that one?
I'll take that one.
And second. Who was that? Was that Ms. Cherry?
No.
Oh,
it's Denise.
Oh, Denise. All right. Madam Secretary, roll call, please.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Ms. Trombley?
Yes.
Ms. Cherry, yes. Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
And Mr. Ritter?
Yes.
Thank you. Ms. Stephan, the Planning Commission is a recommending body. This will be forwarded to the Township Board for their final consideration. And this will be placed on the Township Board meeting on May 10th. So if you could just show up at that meeting, you're all set here.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, Mr. Thompson, did you have any correspondence with regard to any of these items?
None, and nothing for public comment either.
Thank you. The next item on our agenda is the report of the meeting, the minutes for April 8th, 2021. Is there a motion regarding the minutes?
Madam Chair, I'll make a move that if there are no edits or adjustments to the minutes, that we accept them or approve
them. And I'll support that. I'll support it.
Thank you. Madam Secretary, roll call, please.
Mr. Kurd?
Yes.
Ms. Patton?
Yes.
Ms. Cherry, yes. Mr. DeBartolomeo?
Yes.
Ms. Mosley?
Yes.
Mr. Ritter?
Yes.
And Ms. Trombley?
Yes. Thank you. The motion to accept the minutes of April 8th, 2021 is passed. Next on the agenda, Mr. Thompson, discussion on the next meeting agenda?
Yes, we do have items for the next meeting, for the May 13th meeting. The first is a revised site development plan request from Dees Marine at Metro Parkway and Grossbeck. They're actually addressed on South Nunnally, but they're looking at adding an addition to the storage building that they have in the back. The second thing I have is another new use on Grossbeck. There is still an outlot at right next to the Sonic restaurant. It was actually previously approved as a bank. Bank still owns it, but they've never built that bank. That is coming to you as a Chipotle restaurant. So that will be a special land use because it's a drive-through, and as well, at the same time, site development plan approval. So two cases for that next meeting, and that's all we have.
Thank you. Any other comments from the commissioners at this time? Any other discussion? If there are no other questions or comments or discussion, is there a motion to adjourn?
I move we adjourn. Before Tammy does.
I support Ms. Berry. Before Mr. Kerr does.
That's right.
Motion is raised by Ms. Cherry, supported by Ms. Patton. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
No oppositions. Thank you guys. It's been fun. Oh, Mr. Ritter, we don't act like this all the time.
I doubt it. Yes, I think this might be the norm here.
All right, I do.
Madam Chairman, if I can just add one thing.
Yes.
Before we close, I do want to let everybody know that we did have three bids that came in for the zoning ordinance update. And so I've asked Matt Wallace to take a quick look, and he's going to make some reference calls on our behalf. So I'll be looking at picking a consultant to place on the board meeting coming up soon, not the next one, obviously, and looking at getting this process started of updating the zoning ordinance and bringing it into the 21st century. So I just wanted to bring that to your attention, because obviously Planning Commission is going to be very involved in this process. So.
May I ask one question on that?
Yeah.
There used to be an ordinance committee. Does that still exist?
Not that I'm aware of.
I mean, I was on that years ago.
I can certainly look into it, but I don't really want to committeeize it. You know what I mean? We're going to bring in a consultant who I think is going to do a pretty good job. Obviously, they're working very well at doing these things virtually as far as facilitating comments and public meetings and those types of things. But I can look into it, Ron. I mean, if that's a requirement under the... under the charter or something along those lines, we can do that. But what I was expecting to do is create a committee, and that would be myself, a member of the Planning Commission, a member of the Zoning Board of Appeals, and a member of the Township Board. That's how I've done it in the past. And then obviously each of those the Planning Commission and the board will be reviewing it. It won't go in front of the Zoning Board, but certainly we want their comment. And I know there's other committees that are out there, like the Conservation Committee, that is looking to provide some input and maybe get some new ordinances in there that we have. So once we pick that consultant, I think I'd like to keep the group small, because this isn't really a complicated issue. This is things like our second petitioner this evening, and not making uses like this go through special land use that are now more mainstream. And it means updating our site plan ordinance so that we get more information, and it's very clear when site plans are required and when they're not, because we've had some confusion as of late as to what that is. So those are the kinds of things. We're not going to be preparing a brand new zoning ordinance. We're only going to be updating the one that we have. So.
Okay, good.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you, everybody.
All right. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Good evening.
Thank you, everybody.